Welcome to Art-Infusion. Today, we are from Finding Neverland, interviewing the brilliant Daniel Leigh. He is a musician, and he's going to be part of our art exhibition. So, Daniel, tell us about yourself.
Hello, Rebecca. My name is Daniel Leigh. I am the singer in a band called New Device. I will be playing at the art exhibition solo, just me and the guitar. I've been in music for about 10 years now. It's pretty much what I do and what I live, breathe, sleep, eat, and drink.
How many years have you been playing?
Playing? What, the guitar or singing or anything?
Playing and singing.
Best part of, I guess 15 years.
Wow. How old are you?
Personal questions. I'm 27.
27. Tell me, what was your latest hit or your latest album?
My latest record has been a solo record, actually, called My Little Eye, which is under my name, Daniel Leigh. It was something I felt that I just needed to do. I'd had all these songs, but they weren't right for my band or any other project that I had, so I decided to release them myself.
Okay, well, hold on a second. Your Little Eye? How comes that name?
What, My Little Eye? What does it mean to you, Rebecca? This is the interesting point with this, because I chose this title because when I say to people, what does it mean? And they always give me like completely different things. And it's almost like a Rorschach test when, you know, you show people the ink blots and stuff, and they say, to me that's like John Wayne sitting on a horse, or to me that's like a woman in the kitchen doing her laundry or anything. What does it mean to you? That's what I'm interested in.
My grandmother used to say, only silly people reply to you with the same question. So my question originally was, why the little eye?
Well, because it has so many different meanings, because it can mean something to you, which I'm most interested in, and it means something else to me. To me, it was something very cheeky. It has a very cheeky... No, I'm not saying.
I want to know that. That's what I'm here for. That's why I ask the personal questions. And I love Daniel. We've been friends for years, so don't worry.
We have been friends for years, but don't think that that's going to like get out like really personal things out there to the public. Basically, My Little Eye.
You have a little eye?
I... Depends. It could be I Spy with My Little Eye. It could be the third eye, so it would be something mysterious. Or what else could your little eye be, basically? What do you think it could be? If someone has a little eye, it could just be like a really small person with a little eye.
Maybe a little Daniel with one eye.
Never mind.
So tell me give me some titles for that album or for that record.
The tracks in it. Mm-hmm. There's a song called Full Flow, which that was pretty much, I'd say, was like my masterpiece, because we got in this, like, we recorded a whole orchestra.
Wow.
For it. It was really incredible. I'm not classically trained, so getting in all the musicians and stuff and recording it painstakingly.
Tell me, I know that you opened for Bon Jovi. Tell me about that experience.
That was a very surreal experience. We opened up for Bon Jovi at the O2, the O2 Arena, and we were handpicked, I believe, by Richie Sambora, Bon Jovi's guitarist, and it was one of the greatest experiences I've ever done. One of the most challenging things I've ever done as well, because I was very ill at the time.
Yes.
And having to, the weeks leading up to it, I'd just come off tour, and I was really, really nervous about it. And I thought, it's okay, I'm ill, but I'll get better in 2 weeks. If you're nervous about something, you will worry yourself sick. But I pulled through it, and it was a fantastic show. We were treated really well, and playing in front of 23,000 people at the O2 Arena is certainly an experience. It was wonderful. Yeah.
And they were good guys?
Yeah, really good guys. It was wonderful. One of the best experiences from it was watching them sound check, because their keyboard player, I forget his name now. You know them, don't you?
Yep.
Yeah, he'd been flown back to New York early that morning, because he was up for I think 8 awards or something, because he'd co-written a song or something.
Yeah,
and
he's a songwriter.
Yeah, and a really good songwriter. And this song he was co-wrote was up for this awards and stuff. So Bon Jovi was like, we don't have a keyboard player. So they got in this guy that he'd worked with before, and Bon Jovi was on stage teaching him the song. So he's going, and he's singing really quietly, because, aww, you know, he hasn't warmed his voice up. So he's going, so it's faith, faith, now you're gonna live through the rain. And it's just like, wow, you know, I was just trying, I was just really overwhelmed.
He was teaching him, but you were learning yourself.
I was watching how this guy worked, and he was just have fun with it. You know the track, just enjoy it, have a great time. And
nice guy, then.
Really, really down to earth, but he was there was no way you could mistake him for being the boss. Everyone was focused, everyone watched what he was doing, and he was just very calmly conducting everyone, and it was very inspiring seeing how he worked.
Mm-hmm. Talking about inspiring, something that really touched me about Daniel, not just because he's my friend, he's down to earth person and so talented, but also he teaches young kids how to play music, and that is something so moving. Tell me, I know that they are hard work and all that.
Kids are hard work. Yeah.
But tell me more about that.
Well, I got involved with a rock school which was set up down in Newbury, a company called Let's Play Rock, I believe. And we teach, it's basically it's a master class where we teach them all the songs that they want to learn. I know it says it's rock school, but... You know, and when you sort of say school, kids are going to be like, oh, just come out of school, and it's the holidays, etc. But we really make sure that the ethos behind everything is that they just have a good time, and they really do, and they keep coming back. And I always look, by the end of the week, I'm finished. I've just come off of a rock school 2 days ago, and I feel so tired, but I know in a couple of days I'll be looking forward to going back and teaching them again. And they're more famous than us now. It's ridiculous.
Tell me which one are your favorites, if you can say.
We have the mini band, and the mini band are
I love the mini band.
You go on YouTube, Google. What's next for me? My band new device. I'm going to be pushing my solo record, but my band new device have an album which we've just finished recording. I'm back in the studio tomorrow for some more mixing sessions, but the next stage for me with that is to get the album finished. We got video shoots coming up, we have a documentary on us coming out, we have photo shoots to do, music videos, touring the album. So, and then I have all the other projects that I'm getting underway, but my main focus is going to be new device.
Perfect. So I wish you all the luck.
Thank you.
And we will see him in our art exhibition.